Once you have the ability to measure and manage your PUE, the first step in terms of reducing your data center energy load is to focus on the management of the airflow. The most important thing here is to eliminate the mixing of the hot and the cold air. And there's no one right way to do this. Containment can be achieved through many different approaches. One thing that we found very useful at Google is CFD analysis to see where are your hot spots and how is your airflow going to actually be directed in your data center. By doing so, you can actually model the way in which airflow will go, and it helps you make very simple design choices to improve the airflow in your data center. For example, in one of our computing and networking rooms, we call them CONRs, we actually did some thermal modeling to see exactly what airflow was doing. Through that modeling, we realized that the intake to our cracks was too low, and that by simply piecing together some sheet metal, we could create extensions that would dramatically increase the airflow quality into the cracks. We also did a bunch of other retrofits.
Here in this corporate data center at Google, we've implemented meat locker curtains that are very inexpensive and easy to install. These are hung from the overhead structure and they separate the cold aisle, which is actually hot, and the hot aisle, which is actually hotter. We are set now to enter the hot aisle containment door, and we incorporated the simple, inexpensive sheet metal doors to separate very tightly the cold aisle from the hot aisle. Now over here, we've got the hot air from the racks are coming up, going overhead, up through the return air plenum, back to the crack units to give you a nice high temperature differential across your crack units. A very important step is to seal the rack space where you don't quite have all of your equipment populated. And it's very easy to do with these blanking panels. It's almost like weatherizing your house. Make sure that you've got a nice, tight environment.
All told, we spent about $25,000 in parts, and those $25,000 saved us over $65,000 in energy costs yearly.